Each question below is followed by two arguments numbered 1 and 2. You have to decide which of the arguments is a strong argument and which is a weak argument. And you have to give the answer if only argument 1 is strong, option 2 if only argument 2 is strong, option 3 if either 1 or 2 is strong, option 4 if neither 1 or 2 is strong, and option 5 if both 1 and 2 are strong. So basically, if you see, options are all based on strong arguments. So we have to identify which is a strong argument from the given two arguments, right? So look at the statement. Should corporate India be made to foot the higher education bill? Now, understanding the given statement is important, first of all, right? Should corporate India, what do you mean by corporate India? The, you know, corporate sector of India be made to foot the higher education bill? Meaning, should they be made to, contribute for the higher education bill? See, higher education bill means what? For higher education, the government spends a lot of money, right? So, should corporate India be made to participate in that spending, right? The corporate world or the corporate sector of India, right? Be made to participate in that spending is the question here, right? Now, look at the arguments. I mean, the arguments for this. Argument 1 says, yes, corporate India should be made to, fund that higher education bill. Why? It says the government provides huge subsidy on higher education. If corporate India comes forward, the burden on exchequer can be reduced. So you need to understand the context again, right? He says, yes, this is a strong argument because, strong or weak, we have to decide. But he says, yes, corporate India should be made to, participate in this higher education bill because the government provides huge subsidy on higher education. You understand the meaning of subsidy, right? Government, subsidizes the education. Although the cost of getting higher education is, let's say, 1 lakh rupees a candidate, 1 lakh rupees a student, the student is charged only 50,000 rupees. The remaining 50,000 is sponsored by the government, right? The rest of 50,000 is sponsored by government. So that is like subsidizing it, right? So the government provides huge subsidy on this. If corporate India comes forward, if they come forward and say, okay, we will also contribute in this, then the burden on exchequer is nothing but the government here, right? So the burden on exchequer can be reduced. Yes. So if corporate India comes forward and they say that out of the other 50,000, we will spend 20,000 per candidate, so the burden on government has come down, right? So this is the argument. This is why it should be done is the argument. Now, is it strong? Yes, I think in my view it is strong because, corporate India, I mean, not that all the corporate companies are making profits, but this is like a CSR, right? I mean, every company has their CSR, corporate social responsibility. So out of that, let's say if they do it, then definitely the burden can be reduced. See, the government is not, I mean, this argument is not saying that the government will not do it. The argument only says that the government's burden will reduce, right? It's not that corporate India should only spend. It's that they can also contribute or they should also contribute so that the exchequer will save something and it can be used for other things. Right. Look at second argument here. Now, this is against. See, one is for argument, the other is against argument. Now, this is an against one. It says no. Corporate India should not be allowed to do this. No. Why no? Because this will give an excuse to the government to get rid of social obligations. So, he's saying if we make it mandatory, then this will be like an excuse for the government to get rid of social obligations. Well, I don't think that's the intent behind the whole question here, the statement here, right? The government is not trying to, get rid of this social obligation, right? They are only trying to get them participate in this so that the burden can be reduced. I mean, if you go by argument. So, I would say argument one is strong, second one is weak. I mean, of course, some of us can say that, no, this is correct. Second one is correct. This will be like an excuse for government, right? All that can happen. But which is strong? First one is a strong argument. The second one is not really strong, right? First one is a strong argument because that will reduce the burden on exchequer is what it claims. Second one says this will be excuse for the government and it will enjoy and get rid of all the social obligations. They will throw the responsibility on corporates. But that's not really a strong argument, right? So option one in my view, and I think most of you agree with me, that only argument one is strong.